Merry me and welcome to Lux Dragon Queen Magic. I'm Taylor and today we're going to be going over ways to celebrate Lammas. This is going to also include a candle wax reading as well as an oracle card reading from all of our mystical creatures. And so with that, let's just go ahead and talk about it. So I just have a few things that are represented here. I wanted to go ahead and represent bread because this is the celebration of the first harvest, which most typically is that of grain of some kind. And so this is the kind of offering that is meant to be given during this time, is the best of your grains that has been turned into bread or whatever you've used your grains to turn into. So I did not personally make this bread, that is why I did say slice piece, but I'm going to be going ahead. I'm going to leave it out for nature, but you also, especially since Lammas is actually a celebration of light as well, you can leave it, you can burn it in a fire as well. So I'm going to leave it out to nature for the birds to eat. And then normally squash is a celebration of the coming harvest because normally it is harvested later, but this is actually something that my friend recently harvested and gave me some. So I'm going to cook this up and I'm going to give my best piece again out into nature. And again, you can also just throw this into a nice bonfire that you're having. So this is a great time to have a bonfire and to burn any intentions that you're working through. And if you are working with offerings, you can throw those out there as well. If you don't have anything like this that you can give, you don't have even popcorn to feed to the ducks, that's one of my other favorite quick ways to celebrate Lammas, is you can go ahead and just burn some incense, because incense, as much as is associated with air, it is also associated with offering to the guides and to the spirits, as well as lighting it with fire. So there is still a little bit of an element that connects to the light needed in order to burn incense itself. And so with that, that's really just a few quick ways that you can celebrate this time, is to just find some type of grain that you can offer up or eat in celebration of the holiday, as well as doing a simple candle meditation. So you don't have to do a candle wax reading, which is what we're going to do today, but you also can just light a candle and focus on the flame and allow yourself to enter a meditation with that. Or you can just light candles in your house. Maybe instead of turning on the lights when it gets dark that night, just light some candles. I think I say it often, especially here on the Lux channel, is the fact that we tune into that power of Lux, that power of light, and understanding exactly how much it touches us and how grateful we are for that season. And so with that, I'm going to go ahead and clear these out and we'll get started with our candle wax reading. So to start us off, what is coming through is the need to release what is no longer benefiting us. So there is a sense that the past has been really draining us and that we have been engulfed by the memories that are surrounding us lately, when instead this past actually has no control over us anymore. So this is the season to finally burn away anything that has been holding you back, any past memories, because you truly have come so far. I am hearing that there is so much greatness that you have achieved and that you will achieve even more within your lifetime. So if you do not think yourself capable, it is simply your own mind holding you back. And so if there's anything from your past that you're holding on to, anybody that you're trying to prove yourself to, it is now time to stop looking for approval from them, to stop seeking validation from those outside of yourself, because you are the only one who matters. And as you connect more with a higher self, you're going to connect more with that energy as well. And so with this, you are going to find yourself on a path that you did not expect you to take, but this opportunity is meant for you. It literally is a golden opportunity, and someone else would not be able to manage it. You are meant to take that path. You are meant to take those steps forward, and you will find victory and success along this path. And so no matter if others are saying negative things towards you, that is only simply because they could not manage the life that you are living. Yes, the main message coming through is the fact that you will see victory along your path and understand that, again, it is meant for you. That is the energy that is truly going to circle around you. That is why the shadows may seem longer right now, because you were about to enter into a time when the light is just as great. Another thing that's coming through is I'm really seeing like caterpillars forming and wanting to go into a transformation, thinking that it is their time, ready for this transformation. And the truth is that you are not a caterpillar anymore. You are just simply ignoring the wings that you have. There's also a question here around the fear of failure. Understand that as delicate as you may seem during this time, that you are still able to carry yourself so far with the wings that you have grown. You have learned the lessons that you're meant to within this lifetime. You will still learn more lessons, do not get me wrong, but you are meant to move forward. You are meant to fly higher than those around you. So if it feels bad because you're leaving those behind, it is not that you are leaving them behind. It is just that you are meant for a different life path than they are. And you are still able to maintain certain connections within this world, but there are others where you have to build up firmer boundaries. You are not meant to question yourself. Do not allow those negative doubts to seep in, and do not allow them to become your own voice. You have conquered that voice inside of your head. There is also a message here, again, about diverting paths, and you will be given a choice between both. You will be able to see both paths for quite a while before they become so far separate that you no longer see that other path. So understand that you are truly seeking balance, and you are a balanced individual. Another message here is that you are building a great foundation. So understanding that when you build a great foundation means sometimes when you're so focused on getting towards the top, instead understand that the foundation you're building is going to be so stable, and that's why you're still in this part of your path. You are simply building a greater foundation. So if it feels like you are constantly tearing down walls, or if you feel like you haven't moved far enough, it is because you are getting yourself to a point where you will be able to move up faster and higher than anyone else has before. So just be patient with yourself. Give yourself the grace that you deserve. It is okay to focus on one step at a time and to do that step greatly. You also are going to be entering into a treaty of sorts with a community around you. So you are going to be involved with a group of leaders outside of yourself, but you are still going to be an individual within this group, and they will recognize you for your worth and seek your counsel, but also understand that they will work to undermine you as well, because that is just simply what happens with those who are not connected to such higher divinity, while you are able to see all. So you are very connected, intuitive, and trust that intuition. Trust that you know what is best during this moment in time for yourself. This is also a great time, if you are unsure of your future, to just set down clear things that you want, to quiet down your mind and simply ask yourself, what do you want? The whisper of your soul will answer you and help guide you along the path that you need to go. Again, you are building up and layers of protection around you. You have become so strong. You are so intelligent. It's such a main message coming through. You are worth every step that you are taking. Any time that it seems like you are taking a detour, it is not a detour, but simply a moment where you're going to gain new tools and understanding in regards to how to pursue your path even more. Something else coming through is the fact that you are like the salmon, someone who returns home and fights against the current, but not just fights against the current, overcomes it, because it is within your nature. You are able to overcome obstacles that place themselves before you as if they naturally... It's so interesting. So they're not like obstacles others are placing before you. It's almost as if it is part of your nature to encounter these obstacles. There are many loopholes within your path, and you are able to see those loopholes, but understand that a lot of times you are not able to take shortcuts because you simply see the loopholes because you recognize where the negativity within the life is happening. But you are able to focus along the path, and instead of taking the loopholes, you're able to find the way that you're meant to walk, even if sometimes it seems like you're crossing paths, crossing where you've been before multiple times. You are going to be meeting with someone very similar to you very soon. This is outside of that community. They may be associated with that community, but they will not be the leader within that community. They will be a secondary person within that community. Instead, though, you two are pillars of each other, reflections of each other, twin flames, if you will. that is a message coming through for someone for sure. But there is something to be said around the fact that you are going to be meeting this person. You will have had different life paths, but you will have such similar thinking, and there will be similar circumstances that you have gone through, and just an understanding. So if you are worried that this person does not understand you, that will not be the case. And together you will create something bigger than that community. That is why that community of leaders is going to try to keep you apart. Instead, what's going to happen is you will be able to find a way to connect with each other and build something great, even while still supporting that community. And that's why that community will not let you go, or will not be able to hinder you in your external actions with this individual, because instead you will be working closely with the community and still supporting them to where they still need you in order to benefit and have their own goals manifested. So do not think that you're being taken advantage of completely, because you are, but you are also achieving what you are setting out to do. And you are not going to be compromising any part of your soul. You are going to be growing your soul, and you're going to be meeting many different people along the way, very diverse people. And you're going to learn so much within the coming months about yourself and about the world and how it operates around you. Simply do not be afraid is a message coming through. It may not seem connected, all the events that have led you to this point, but they are as if it was a storybook written. Sorry, I interrupted myself. If you are experienced with the Akashic Records, then you will know that there is a book already written that has told about your path, your present, and your future. You have access to this information, even if it may seem as if you are dumb when you try to access that information. But simply work with your spirits, with your higher self, to understand how to read that information again. You are not meant to know your full future. You are only meant to see a little steps ahead of you that otherwise, the fog is so dense. But when you are within the fog, again, remember the light that is within you, the light that you have, and understand that as you move forward, as you learn to shine brighter, you start to clear up that fog that is around you, and you start to see clearer and clearer at each moment. Again, the shadows may be long, but your light is just as bright. You are soon going to be entering the second phase of your awakening. Do not be afraid. Your partner, this person that you meet, they will also be stepping into their second awakening. They also will be afraid. You will be mirroring each other, your emotions. But somehow through this, you will become brave for each other, because it is as if you are looking within a mirror, and you will take on that energy to be brave enough for both of you in order to transcend into something greater. And this energy will become more consistent for you. This energy will become something that defines you more in the future. This braveness, this courage. Again, there is going to be many pieces coming together in order for you to understand more about this, like a ladder leading you up. There are many steps to a ladder. And if you have ever built a ladder, or just thinking about what it takes to build a wooden ladder, it has many components to it. At first, it may seem like two separate sticks, and then when you put the rungs together, it is up to you to determine how far apart those rungs are to make it feasible for you to take those next steps forward. So understand that this ladder is being built in an odd way. It is not so straightforward. And so sometimes you can see the top rung or a few rungs ahead of you, but you do not have the length that you need in order to reach it. And so there is simply a missing step, but you will find that missing step, and it will be placed before you as you need it and truly need it. Yes, there is great power coming within you. There is a message coming to you very soon that is going to help clear up this next step, and you will level up. Yes, you will level up. There is activity happening externally around you in this moment and in this time. Do not fear the messages that are coming. Simply connect more. Connect more with nature as well, because that is how you'll be able to support the quieting of the external world, so that you can truly understand more about what you are building and growing. Because these roots that you have, they go so much deeper than you truly understand and explore. Something coming through is the understanding that sometimes there is root rot. There are things that have happened that may seem to diminish you, but instead understand that as you cut away from that past, from that energy, you will instead find new roots growing that are stronger. You will be able to see, rather feel exactly how this new energy supports you rather than diminishes you. It all comes from within you. That is our messages for today. The last thing that will be said here in regards to our candle wax reading is that there is this energy of enlightenment around you. There is this energy of wings around you. So however that resonates for you, whether it be your own beautiful butterfly wings, whether it be those dragon wings that you have encased yourself for so long, they are finally spreading. It also is a call to understand that you do have spirits and angels around you supporting you and the energy and person you're becoming. You are at the center of all of this, and this energy is welcoming you and broadening you. You are going to be okay, and you are going to... Expand. You're going to be expanding so much within the next coming weeks. So even more so than months, within the next coming weeks, you are going to be expanding. And there is a comment here around the fact that yes, part of the time it will seem lonely. Even when you connect with that partner, you will not fully come together yet. But that is because you are such an individual right now that you are needing that room and space to grow, and then they are also going to grow, and then you will overlap each other, and that is when you will come into true reunion. All right, thank you for our candle wax reading. Let's go ahead and step into our oracle reading. Okay, to start us off with our mystical creatures, we do have the Pegasus Oracle coming out. I love this first one coming out for us. It is the Pegasus of Roses. This is also the Pegasus that denotes the divine feminine. And so this is letting us know that we are entering into a period where we're recognizing the divine feminine within us, whether that be ways how we're expressing our emotions more authentically, and we are creating firm, not necessarily firm boundaries, but we're creating a safe space where we're able to truly be who we want to be. And we have been able to create that space, not just for ourselves, but for those around us who really care and support us. The other thing too, a message coming through, is that we are recognizing the beauty of ourselves and the beauty of our life. And so you are a powerful and divine being. I need you to know that. And this is why this card is coming out, because you are recognizing more of the luxury that is you, the luxury of your own life. No matter how far you've come, no matter where you have been, you are coming into the sense of where you are just being romantic by the great divine, and you can feel that energy. Things just seem to be happening for you. So at this time, you truly are able to manifest anything and everything that you want to manifest. So moving into it, we do have Pegasus and the Great Mountain. So this is a call to the fact that you are returning home into this energy. You are aligning into that greater sense of being that you are yet again. So this is going to be a very big theme message coming through here, is this leveling up that you are going through, and the fact that you are becoming just so much more authentic. There is also a message here saying that you are backed by the universe for the person that you are becoming. So every time that you quiet yourself and tune into that higher being, you are able to recognize exactly where that divinity has come from within you. And no matter what you call that divinity within you, or how you recognize it, be it from a connection to Jesus, to a god, to Shiva, to perhaps one of the Greek gods, or perhaps you just like to call the universe, perhaps you see yourself as a starseed, however you view yourself, it is just recognizing the fact that you are on the right course, that you do recognize the fact that you come from a greater home than simply this earthly presence that you're currently living. There is something more divine within your soul. And then next we do have the Red Pegasus of Firelight. And so this coming out for us is reaffirming the fact that we do have manifestation within us. The other thing that it's reaffirming, as much as the Great Mountain is more closely related to our crown chakra, to those higher levels of us reaching out and communicating to the universe, The red Pegasus is associated with our root chakra, with us being grounded within this world. And so you are connecting to your full body, recognizing just how fully human and fully divine that you are. So again, with its divine feminine, you're recognizing that higher sense of self, as well as recognizing the beauty that is around and within you. And so taking in all of this energy, you are achieving a certain balance that is simply divine. There is no other way to put it, because it is simply divine. It is simply lovely. And so I'm encouraging you to just enjoy this moment in time. Enjoy the present that you are in. Do not worry about the future so much, because you are currently on the right path. You are doing everything that you are meant to do. You are fully rooted in the person that you're being. There is a message here that maybe you have not been as connected to feeling very stable within your life. This is a message letting you know that you are stable. Again, you are backed by something greater within this universe. So at that time, if you are feeling unstable, if you are feeling unreliable, if you are feeling abandoned in any way, unfulfilled, know that that is simply in this moment in time, because you have this energy within you. These are blessings coming to you from the Pegasus. And then healing with our angels, we do have serenity. So yes, if you do not feel at peace right now, this is a call saying that you can feel at peace. Everything at this time, plus there's flowers, so much more beauty. Recognizing the nature around you, finding that peace within, is going to be so supportive in helping you find the serenity that you have, that harmonious feeling that just simply exudes around you within your aura. The other thing too I'm hearing is that people are seeking you out for this energy. So if you have been feeling overwhelmed with external people coming to you and pulling your energy in all certain sorts of way, it's because they recognize this within you. But you have all the power in your world, again, to take back, settle into your root, into your foundations, and say, these are my firm boundaries. This is where I'm at in this current moment. So these, both of these have some sort of structure around them where you are able to say, hey, there is a limit, there is a boundary here of how much I'm able to express to others and how much I am able to support others before I can support myself. You have to take care of yourself before others. Okay, and then we do have emerging, which a big message coming out during this season is the fact that you are emerging into something greater. These are the same flowers. Interesting. I don't know flowers that well, so I can't tell you what these flowers are. So if you know what they are, I would encourage you to take that there, because these are duplicating messages that are here to remind us that this is all folding into each other as it is meant to. So as you're finding this sense of peace, you are then emerging into something greater. Something that's coming through is the message that sometimes birth is so messy and chaotic during all of that pain and pressure that is going through in a moment when the actual birthing happens. Right after, there is a sense of calm and peace that typically happens before the screaming child takes over, of course, but just that energy that exudes within the room. So that is kind of what's happening right now. So again, if you're feeling unsettled, this is a message letting you know that it is because, I apologize, because this is a message that is pulling through you, because if you feel unsettled, it is simply because you are moving through a very, well, traumatic time of your life, a very changing time of your life, especially what we channeled during the candle wax was the fact that you're going through a second ascension. A second ascension is no joke. It is leveling up into something greater than what most others are not able to achieve. And so if you're feeling chaotic right now, this is why. But there is such a firm message here that you have serenity gifted to you as you need it. That energy exudes outside of you. So if it seems like you can't maintain it within, it's because you're simply letting it go to too many other people. So again, just return back to you, return back to source, find that peace that is within you. And as you do so, you will start to find exactly how you're emerging into the person that you truly want to be. So a very big message here around quieting those external voices, quieting the canopy of chaos that exists around you, so that you can hear that whisper of your soul and what you truly want. And with that, we do have some magical friends coming through. Okay, so we have love. Listen to your heart, embrace what makes you happen. There are a million and one reasons to love. So I very much enjoy this energy because we are connecting with that divine feminine side, that side of us that lets us be just who we need to be and who we want to be. And again, big message around quieting the chaos outside of you so that you can hear the internal peace. And so this is one of the best ways that you can do that, is connecting to something that you love again. I, for instance, have started reading again. It has been fantastic, and I'm so excited to introduce that to my schedule more often. And so with that, this is simply a call for you to recognize that if you have not been doing what you love lately, to make time, prioritize time for you to do these things again. And then this also can be a message in regards to connecting to that divine partner too, because the reality is we did have a little bit of that message coming through. We did have a divine fem card come through. There's a lot of divine fem energy here within this, but there is also this sense of being protected and supported in the external as well. And so there is more to this life than simply what is pulling you apart. There are ways to bring yourself back together. I feel like I'm repeating a little bit, so I apologize, but the messages were pretty firm in the candle wax reading. And then next we do have sanctuary. So embrace the need for solitude. Your inner sanctuary calls you. Renew yourself and thrive. So you guessed it. If you haven't found yourself a way to connect with your internal self, again, finding what you need, what you love, finding a quiet place in nature, you are needing to create this sanctuary. There is a firm message here that this sanctuary you have probably already created and you just haven't visited in a while, but it is something that you have already built the foundation of and that you're going to be able to step into. So you are going to find this renewal that you need so that you can step into the light that you were meant to embrace. Okay, and then from our dragons, okay, we have the self, morals and intellect. Okay, so this is a very interesting one because it's not just about being smart, it's not just about being intellectual, but it's also about, again, connecting to that heart space in regards to our morals and what we know within our divine selves, what is right and what is wrong. And so understanding truly where we place our morals and what that means, and then following through on those situations and being courageous enough to stand up in those moments when we need to. But being smart, so you don't need to be aggressive in order to follow through with your morals. You simply need to have firm boundaries. And that is a firm message here, that you do have those. It's just simply time for you to recognize and feel the ability to be able to exercise those boundaries. Okay, then, because we do have the Spriggan, gossip and rumors. And so this is a warning. This is letting you know a bigger reason for you to connect with those morals and to gain that intellect, because you are going to rise above this gossip and rumors. You are not meant to drag yourself down into this energy. Again, find love for the situation, because there is empathy to be had. Even if it seems like you are not being, if no one is holding empathy for you, then it's such a hard message to say, because injustice is literally so unfair. But understanding that you want your actions, your thoughts, and your beliefs to reflect your morals and how you want to interact within this world. And so that means not engaging with the gossip or the rumors, maybe giving benefit of the doubt when it makes sense. So follow that intuition. Again, you're not just saying, oh yes, here, abuse me, take advantage of these boundaries that I very clearly set up. No, instead you're saying, ah, interesting, I'm going to go ahead and interact with this individual less, or ah, interesting, maybe this is the case or maybe this isn't. I'm going to move forward in a smart way that protects me for either, while not also hurting this other individual in case it ends up being false. And so just again, connecting to that inner space where the truth truly lies for you is so important. You are smart, you're so smart. Okay, and then next we do have air coming through, intuition and knowledge. So that pretty much just really, especially I love that these are on either side of gossip and rumors. And so this is letting us know, again, exactly what we just said, that you are so smart, you can trust that energy within you. You have spirit and the element of air around you. So that is typically associated with the Suit of Swords as well as the message coming through. Something that is able to cut through. The other thing too is Swords is also associated with just pens and words and writing, and so understanding that you're able to see the truth of the situation. So don't take everything you read or hear for fact. Instead, mull it over and take it through your internal processing, and then what comes out, may it be a diamond or a coal, you will then better know. Perhaps it is not either of those. Perhaps it is still an unknown factor. And so don't simply decide in the moment, because you don't have to. There is always a way. There is always a middle path forward, is a message coming through. So recognize again that you can take a step back from any of this negative energy. You can have those boundaries. Anyone who won't let you have those boundaries means that you just need to create firmer boundaries with them. We've been saying that a lot lately, so someone definitely needs to hear it. And truly understand that you can trust yourself above all else, and understand what is the basis for that trust, for that intellect, for that intuition, for the reasons why you're choosing to move within this world. Okay. With that, we now have messages from our mermaids. And so we have asked for help. So as you work through this, again, you are connecting to that higher source. You are being able to connect to that great mountain, and you're able to connect to a home space that is greater than what you've ever known. So something coming through is, for some of you, this really is just connecting to maybe your parents or a wise elder who has those messages for you, who is able to help you understand more without telling you what to do or how to choose. They simply give you advice. That is a big message coming through here today, is no one is telling you what to do. If they are, they're the ones, that is not a person for you to listen to, because if they're telling you what to do, they're not allowing you the choice to listen to your own intuition, to listen to your own intellect. So asking for help is simply gaining advice. So also connecting to that higher self, maybe tuning into the Akashic records, as we mentioned earlier, that is going to be how you ask for help, and how you can recognize when it's truly helpful versus not. Is, are they telling you what to do, or are they simply giving you good suggestions? Perhaps two sides of the story. If you can find two sides to the story, that is always better. Okay. And then we do have breaking free. And so this is letting us know there is a very big message here, that you're breaking free from this drama of typically what you have been associated with in the past. You're breaking free from this energy of someone who brings this drama to you. And instead, you're recognizing again this need for firmer boundaries with that individual, whoever they may be. So just simply take that for whatever it may be, but understand that you are free. You are free. And then next, we do have be spontaneous. So this is so great, because this is actually coming through as a message for how to connect with your intuition. And so whenever you get a feeling within your heart, within your soul, and you're like, I want to do this right now, do it. Especially if it doesn't harm others, then that is even better. Especially if all of a sudden you're like, well, these are the reasons why I can't do this right this second. That means even more you should come up with reasons why you can do it, because you have intuition and knowledge, you have intellect, you have reasons why you want to move forward. So something too coming forward is, you can be spontaneous when you need a break. Spontaneous doesn't mean, ah, yes, I need to go out into the world right now and do this thing. It could also be, you know what, I need to take a step back, and I need a moment to think and rest. Being spontaneous is just changing your mind in the moment on what you are currently about to do. Okay? And then we do have discernment. So the biggest lesson of all that has come through during this reading is the fact that you have this skill, you have discernment, you are able to recognize what is truth and what isn't truth. And you are able to decide what energy you take into yourself and what energy you say, no, thank you. You cannot come into my heart. You cannot come into my soul and start messing up what I have already purified within here. So I encourage you to practice with that. And it just comes back to ask for help. So if you're unsure at any moment, your skill is still discernment. You can still ask for help, gain new information, and then go back and discern what you learned from that information. So some very big messages came through during this holiday. I hope you guys are celebrating in such a fun way. Don't forget to leave some comments below. Let us know what you're doing. And if you need any suggestions on exactly how to celebrate within a very busy schedule, feel free to comment below and I will help you do that. But with that, I'm going to leave you guys here. I want to thank you all for liking and subscribing. And I will definitely see you guys next time. Blessed be.